Hi, Ann Morrison with another installment of My Furniture Set. Now let's see, we've been with a cocktail table, who also poses as a coffee table, a sofa, a throw pillow, a dining room table, an easy chair, a vase, painting sequence, an old desk, which took me into my bedroom, so it's only natural now we go into the Bed Trilogy. Enjoy. Always wear cute pajamas when you go to bed at night. You never know who you're going to meet in your dreams. La 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 la. Da 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 dee da da dee da da da. Ba da 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 da. I had a wonderful time tonight.
What are you going to do about walnuts?
You know, it's the first time in my life I felt like the opposite sex.
What are you going to do about Warren?
I wonder if he's going to ask me out tomorrow night.
What are you going to do about Warren?
What am I going to do about Warren? Oh, Warren doesn't care.
Warren cares.
Warren cares. Well, I don't care.
You have to care because you're engaged to him. And you don't have to care about him because how do you know he cares about you? Then what are you going to do?
What did you say? When you know there's someone loving you, and you know there's someone you love too, and they're not the same, what do? Go to sleep, girl. Go to sleep, go to sleep. Close your eyes and hide from every care. When you wake up, they may not be there. But tell me, how can I sleep? Tell me who could when you see your whole life tangled up. Good, I could drink, I could weep, but tell me, how can I sleep? Go to sleep. And when you and someone have a date,
when you were thinking straight,
and when you and someone stay out late, but I had to, and they're not the same, who gets the gate?
This is not the way to find a mate.
Go to sleep, girl. Go to sleep, go to sleep.
Go to sleep, go to sleep.
Comes the dawn, I might not feel the same.
Comes the dawn, he may not know your name.
In the sunlight, who can see a flame? Well, tell me, how can I sleep? Look what I've done, mess around with two men. Soon you have none, as you sow, so you reap, which is why I can't sleep. Go to sleep.
Go to sleep.
Go to sleep. I could die here tonight, all alone here in my bed, alone in this most neglected of rooms, with sheets that clash and mismatched socks and ragged old fruit overlooms. And when my body is found cold and prone here in my bed, in more than its usual state of decay, they'll all look round at my drab life and instantly
foul play. No empty bottles of pills, no motive to debate, no violent scene, just crumbs on an empty plate. Death by saltine. I could die here tonight, die unknown here in my bed, and yet it is too abundantly clear that even the act of being dead would only be redundant here in my bed.
Because it's far too sentimental, and I don't want you to think I care enough to write a mushy love song now that you and I are really through. Oh, by the way, two bills are also there. One from the cable, which has really kept me sane throughout the breakup. Damn, swore I wouldn't dwell upon the breakup. Well, the other is my Visa bill, a little heavier with all the junk I bought to kill the pain, to fill the space until I face the fact that you and I are definitely through. There's my talking clock now set to get me off to work the new job you don't know I've got. It's not impressive, it won't make you think I'm doing well without you. Actually, I'm not so hot, I can barely hack it. And there are those earplugs I still wear to help sleep tightly through the nightly New York racket. Did you find one recently? Did it make you think of me and cry so hard you couldn't see? I hope so. But then it really shouldn't matter. I also fondly hope you're growing fatter. There's a lamp that never makes me think of you. We never shop for it together, and you never put the lampshade on your head. It's by the bed so I can see to fill my journal with the 3 gazillion reasons why we're better off apart. Or rather, why I'm better off without you. You, of course, have lost the greatest catch you'll ever have, and you will realize how much you care and languish in complete despair until your dying day, which won't be soon because you're so damn healthy with your veggie diet and your yoga, which I tried that time. I had that awful cold. It nearly killed me. But I did it to impress you, since I never did believe that you could love me just for me. On my bedside table, there are 3 stones which I'm told have healing energy. They say you have to touch them all the time or they'll disintegrate. I feel like I'll disintegrate if someone doesn't touch me soon. But there were years before I met you, and I have my note from Sondheim, and my Visa, and my cable, and my talking clock and earplugs, and my healing stones and journal to unwind me and remind me that I always have myself.
and I always have the lyrics to a new song and the lamp that never makes me think of you.
You know what they say, if you don't have two bedside tables, you only have a one night stand.